IVM.
Before we got started on Varta Lab at IVM, I actually came down to the IVM studio to do another podcast here called Cyrus Says with the Cyrus Brocha. Can you believe it? It was like a super duper superhero moment for me. You can check out Cyrus Says every week on the IVM podcast app on Mondays and Thursdays. It's online every morning and he's an absolute ball of delight. So you should check them out.
Stories, we've got stories. They're a little bit of funny and a little bit of dissimilar. You want to hear them, it's got humans. They're sitting in a box and talking old Edwards all loud.
So a few months ago, we were researching for a show called Mera Kaam Poker, which yeah, we
back
did.
When you were at IVM.
I'm still at IVM, but not as producer. I produced Mera
Kaam
Poker.
Back when you were producing
shows
at IVM,
and we had teamed up with Spartan Poker, the very famous sport poker website, and it was fun because we got to meet so many interesting people through the whole run. Because there are people who are like housewives, there are people who are traders, stock traders,
right,
and film editors who all play poker and are champs at that.
Yeah.
And one name that kept occurring again and again was India's first female pro poker player, who's won the national award, Muskan Sethi, and I sat down to research for Muskan, and I tumbled upon this website, which had information.
Don't give the name of the website.
I won't. Like,
yeah.
They don't.
Let's
require,
not
screw
them.
Screw them for being who they
shady
are.
Shady.
Because, like, you know, when you type Muskan Sethi, they're like height, weight, age, husband, family, biography, and more.
Wow.
I'm like, now I'm interested. So then I scroll down, and it has information about a height, a hair color, eye color, her father, her brother.
Like names.
Names. Like, you know, they have a photo of her dad, but name not known. Okay. Marital status and her tattoo. Like, somebody has a photo of a tattoo from her Instagram and which says, "My parents, my pride."
Wow.
So it's very stalker behavior.
Yeah.
But based on these weird stories that we got from the website, we decided, like, let's do it on Varta Lab.
Absolutely.
Let's get more stories for these websites.
I know for a fact that these websites don't listen to podcasts.
Yeah.
So they are not listening.
Yeah. Instagram is their first base of knowledge.
Yeah. I think they don't go beyond Instagram.
So on Varta Lab, season 2, welcome the very amazing Muskan Sethi.
Hi. Yay. Guys.
Hey.
Hey.
Welcome.
Hi. So nice to be here. I'm seriously, I'm a fan of you guys.
Are you?
Don't lie. Listen, we don't want you to lie and all and say that you've seen us.
No, I actually searched you guys last night, and that's when I became a fan.
Okay, that's not bad. At least you searched us before.
Before, yeah.
Some people don't even bother.
Yeah.
No.
Like, did you search us as much as these guys did?
I'm sending them all your information after this.
Done. I need that. I need people to know what's where on the
body. I actually got really scared. I found this website myself, and I was scared because my father's picture, this, I found it actually very amusing. I showed it to everyone around, and then I was like, my Instagram page has to be like super legit now, because everything about my life is coming out there.
I completely get that. I keep having that fight with my girlfriend where she's like, why don't you put more pictures of me on the thing? And I'm like, because everyone who follows you, you chose. I don't choose who follows me anymore.
And do you think that's a price to pay when you're like a sort of a celebrity? Like, you get in public memory, and then some of them do want to know more about you than you want to share.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, and then, you know, you feel that it's like your responsibility of like telling them that, you know, what you're doing and how you're doing, because you feel that they want to follow the same dreams. They want to also probably get into poker or anything like that. So I entertain most of them and I tell them how to get into poker and how to like learn the game and get the whole knack of it. And sometimes when it's too much, then I also like, you know, it's just, it's always sweet actually. I always get like good wishes from people who are like saying all the best and do well. So whenever you're really down in your career, you can actually look up, you know, you can open your phone and like all these amazing messages.
The validation is coming from Instagram.
But that's amazing. That's like, you need that sometimes to keep going. But you're also a pretty girl in India.
No, but to be honest, it's just that.
See, honesty is good.
But don't lie and all.
No, seriously, it's more like I'm like friendly to everyone. Probably that's what. And I to be, if I can do it, I believe anybody can, because I mean, when I was growing up, I was also like just a normal, like, you know, someone had, I had no great ambitions. I just wanted to do social work. I wanted to chill. I never wanted to be a corporate slave. That was one thing straight. That I don't want to, I wanted to do something creative for sure. And I was in modern school, Barakamba Road in Delhi. So while I was there, I was exploring every thing. Like every week I used to go to my parents and be like, today I want to be this, today I want to be that. Today. Like, you know, they just like, they used to be like, oh, now she wants to do this. Now she, like, you know, it was like a joke that her ambition keeps changing. And when I found poker, I just felt like I found my calling. And I never ever looked back. Like, and I just find like I feel it sane, and I love it. Like,
it's, at what age did you discover the game of poker?
So I was really little, actually. My father used to watch poker on TV. And there used to be on ZTV, I think. They used to show telecasts of WPT tournaments and stuff.
So late at night, no?
Yeah, late at night.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah, I remember this.
So my father used to watch that. And he doesn't even touch cards. He's basically, he was a doctor, but he joined his family business. So he didn't follow his dreams, and he used to just, you know, watch that. And then be like, I love, I have a lot of respect for people who, you know, play this mind sport because it's so interesting and things like that. So I used to be like, what is this, dad? It's so boring. Like, you know, Diwali, those flash is so much more fun, right?
Yeah. So I was like, and all
yeah, like I that was common to see around Diwali. It was like sort of a culture, sort of a thing to just play sometimes. So I was like, that's so much more fun. You know, what is this? This is so boring. And but when I grew up, and like when I was after college and everything, I realized that I actually saw it on Facebook. And then I started playing on Zenga Poker, and I had like all these people who would like specially stay up with me like the whole night and play poker. And I made like a bankroll there, and it was like a joke sort of a thing. But I got really into it, started watching a lot of YouTube videos. Then I realized that I really need the skill to you know, last in this or make this my career or profession. And then I played on this site called Poker Stars. And I played a free roll, so it costed me nothing to play into this tournament. And there were 20,000 people, close to that much. And I had to come top 20. Okay. And if I do that, I get $100 and audition video after send. So I was just playing for actually that $100, because that was my first depositor's free roll. So I was very excited, and I ended up coming 10th in that.
Nice.
Yeah, because like because it was a free roll, I feel like a lot of people were playing like that, and like
no stakes at all.
Yeah, so no, it, but it was very long. Like, it took me like 12 hours to like finish that tournament. And then once I came for whatever happened, I sent my audition video, and then I got selected out of like so many entries. Only 4 people were selected in the world. And then we were flown to Barcelona after a quiz on the phone and everything, like shortlisting. Then they sent us to Barcelona, and they said that you have to play like one table, a sit and go with 6 poker players. And if you beat them, so then you go like in the next round. So basically, I read this ad that you have it in you to beat the pros and be on TV for $1 million. So this was it. So if you beat 2 tables, you, if you come first in 2 tables, you win $1 million. So I came second in that.
You get $500,000 at least.
No.
Oh, that sucks.
That sucks.
Yeah. I was just like, but then to be honest, when I was there sitting and playing with those players who I was watching on YouTube, like so far away in my house, like, there was like, when I used to tell my parents I'm going to go to Vegas one day, they used to laugh. Like, you know, like, try leaving South Delhi. You know, like that. So, you know, just
go to South Goa, in fact.
Yeah, like, wake up. You know, like that. I used to be like, you know, when I'm 36, I'm going to shift there, this, that. I had like all these crazy fantasies. So it was like all coming true for me when I was sitting there playing with those pros and such big names. My one of this, there was this lady, Liv Bury. She's also a PokerStars ambassador for UK, and she is from UK, and she is so amazing, talented, beautiful, and she's achieved so much in her life. She's a social worker as well, interested in science, and like such a great human being as well. So I was always, I used to look up to her. She was my, like, you know, idol, that
Are there a lot of women poker players in the scene?
So, see, the women poker players are, say, I'll say about like just 10%. And you know, the problem is that a lot of women have not tried this.
Yeah.
We have, I was just having this conversation with my friends right now that, you know, it's really important for women to try this, because we have that intuition, we have that decision making, we have patience, we have the time.
I was going to say that, like, intuitively, women have the better poker face, like Lady Gaga said. It just like, it makes more sense. It just makes more sense.
Yeah, it does. And I started off like online, and then gradually I am in the live scene now, or you know, I got.
How different is it? I mean, in online, obviously, you can't see the person's face.
Oh, of course. It is really different. So, but it helps you. So, basically, what happens is when you play online, the other person can't see you.
Yeah.
And I love playing online because nobody knows I'm a woman. The only time I tried convincing the players on my table that I'm a woman on this international side, I was like, basically, they were just like giving me compliments. You're playing really well, dude, bro. So, I just said that I'm a girl, you know, I'm a woman. So, they were like, oh, whatever, haha, yeah, right.
Like, and you can't digest the fact that a woman is whooping their ass.
Yeah, and then someone wrote that, go back to the kitchen.
Wow.
Yeah, and then I was like, what the hell? Now I'm going to show them. Like,
I should go back to the kitchen with all their money.
Yeah. Like, so it was just so funny. So then basically now I don't tell anybody. I just like love just hiding behind my screen name.
What's your screen name?
I've got many screen names. I'm not revealing them right now.
But let me check the website.
Yeah, that website will have all my screen names. But yeah, so it's interesting. So but what happens is online, the difference is you can't see your player. Mm-hmm. But the way, depending on their betting pattern and the way they are playing, you can very well, like after a few hands, decide that how this person plays and how you want to counter back. And live, what happens is you are able to see the person sitting in front of you. You're able to read his body language. But all that is the very last few things you consider when you're making a poker decision. When you're in a hand, you're thinking about the stack sizes, the pot equity, you're thinking about the math and your hand and the combinations. Like, what are the, you're basically thinking about what cards is he holding rather than looking at his body language, because he can also like misguide you.
Yeah.
You know, and you, and even if you try to do that, it might work, might not work. So it's always important to have the skill. And if you're having fun with your friends and all, then you don't have to worry. But even if you want to be the best poker player amongst your friends, you still need to work on your skill.
It gets competitive. Even with friends, like, have you played poker, Akash? I don't know if you have.
The way I look at poker is very different from most people.
Why?
Because, have you ever played poker with me?
Yeah.
You have, right?
Not with you.
Not with me, right?
I played with Karnesh and Vaibhav Sethi.
So you play with the guys who are serious about it.
Yeah.
I know what, this is my idea, okay? I have 1,000 rupees. that I don't want anymore.
Okay.
So then I call 3-4 of my friends. We all bring that 1,000 rupees that we don't want anymore.
Yeah.
We put it in the pot and then we just f*** around all night.
You know, that's a very interesting thing because in bankroll management, that's the first thing they teach you, that you should never touch the money that is important to you and only the money that you're comfortable to
spendable
lose.
Income.
Exactly.
And what you, instead of putting that whole 1,000 next time, I suggest you to play like maybe 10 times with just 100 rupees. So you will give yourself like 10 chances and you might just do well as well.
No, the idea is for us also, like if it's 5 guys and it's 5 grand, then that becomes that night ka khana and everything. No, like we're out for 6 hours.
Yeah.
So instead of spending it at a bar or something, we just get it home and so I mean, it becomes more part of the...
It's such an amazing mind stimulation and it's just so much fun. Like just to like get to know each other and you know, like it's a mind game and like the biggest professionals that I know and they play poker for relaxing. Apart from like so many lawyers, so many doctors.
And the banter they have is so interesting to watch. Like if you watch the big guys play on the websites, they all have like some kind of like banter going throughout and they are like, you know, messing with each other trying to get like...
So egoistic, right?
It's really amazing because I only got into poker after I started working on the show. Like, Mera Kaam Poker was like one of those gateways because I was like, bachpan se ki hai jua hai, and mom said not to play jua, so I'm out of it. But then I understood the math behind it, and I'm bad at maths also. So I'm like, how do I equate this? And they were like, okay, this is what the card holding is, where, this is where it stands, probability theory, as well. I'm like, oh, now it makes sense. I'm like, how much do I hold?
Yeah, you know, so, like, I completely agree with you because the jua aspect is like not cool for me. Like, I went to Goa in the middle and I went to one of those casino boats and I went to the blackjack table. I went to
the river.
Yeah. Okay.
That's not poker.
No. Huh, I know. So I'm at the blackjack table, and the guy says, "Come, let's put some money." I'm like, "Why? I just made this money. I just did this show. Do I really want to risk?" And just the idea, this is $2,000, and I have to wait. I have to literally wait and hope that the money doesn't go away. It's a horrible feeling.
So luckily, my dad always told me that follow your dreams because you're gonna regret it if you don't. And my mother, she brought me up like a tiger. She was like, go out there, get things done. My mother, she was like a social worker, politician, an amazing lady. I have been mentored by her for so many years. And so when people were like, the society was trying to say things to me that, it's gambling. And are you sure you want to gamble for a living? Starting from that school, look at your parents. Your parents are into charity and your father is so respectable. You want to do all these things that you want to bring a bad name to your family. Yeah. And to be honest, when I was a kid also, and I used to win around Diwali and all, I used to do charity. I used to, a lot of people used to say that, Jue ka paisa is not good and things like that. So I used to go do charity. I used to buy a lot of a lot of boxes of food and then randomly distribute them, drive around and distribute them to everyone and just help people that who are not even expecting this money. Because this is an unexpected money, right, for me. But now in poker, I'm
now
doing
it's income,
the same.
Right? You're actually putting in your effort and skill set into something.
Yeah, and
to make
now
it.
I'm able to do much more better charity. I'm able to make plans and projects. I'm doing something for dogs. My next project I really want to do is I want to start dog ambulance and all these things. I want to I already have a community on Facebook called Doggy Do.
Okay.
And I'm so it's
so
like
cute.
Yeah, it is. And it's just everyone posts about their dogs and if they have any problems, and if they even show off privileged pets, or you can show off your privileged pets and you can take care of the underprivileged pets who are not, who are out there in the streets and all. And this problem is a very big one. I thought about it. I stayed in Goa for a few months. I saw the problem there. I'm here in Mumbai. I see a lot of stray dogs here. In Delhi, there are so many stray dogs. I'm really trying to help the situation. That how come we are people and there are so many animals who are
and honestly, the stray dogs will support your life. Basically, they'll protect your area better than your own dogs. They're very territorial and stuff like that.
Yeah, that's cute. But in general, I feel that, poker, you can do great things. For example, charity, or you want to help out your parents, you want to help out you want to pay your college fee, you want to do those kind of things. You can plan it out because you have to put in your skill, and it's basically you put in very minimum risk and you get maximum returns. That's what we are looking for in poker.
Correct.
And the ROI, basically. In any business you do, you want to make the most money, and that's how you want to give yourself more chances. So that's what we do in poker. That's why I really am a big this thing of responsible gaming, because I really want everyone to really manage their bankroll really well, because that's one thing that you don't have the knowledge for when you get into poker. You just feel that, okay, I'm going to hit and run, make some money, go. But you need to know that you got to take a lot of chances and you got to learn the game, understand the game, and you can do even more than you are expecting to do.
Correct.
Yeah.
And being an ambassador in general, you are representing India all over the world right now.
For PokerStars. And it's amazing. I love this opportunity. It's like a dream job.
So what are your favorite experiences having traveled around the world with
tell us some crazy games that you've played and some...
So basically, we play a lot of tournaments. I love playing tournaments. So when you go to Las Vegas, it's so interesting because it's like a mecca of poker. You go there and you will see like thousands and thousands of poker tables. There's large fields. Imagine you can turn for example, I'll tell you, when you go there, when you go to Vegas, you can go with any amount you want. And you can look up and you will find your range of buy-ins and the tournaments you want to play. And there's still so much value. They're million dollars guaranteed, most of the tournaments where, and to be honest, it's not that even if the world's best poker player is on your table, it's not guaranteed that you can't beat him. Or he's going to you know, beat you. Because yeah. there's so much variance in the game. There's so much that you can do to beat the pros and beat the better players. Like, for me, when I'm on the table there, people are like shocked. They're like, you're from India? Okay, you live here, right? No, I'm from India. What? You've come all the way from India to play poker? They have poker in India? Like, you know, they are like shocked.
Yeah, काफी गवार हो रहे लोग हैं. पत्ते नहीं हैं हम लोग के पास. क्या बोल रहे
हैं? हम लोग कैसा घास का पत्ता लेके? You sit with leaves and draw on that.
Toilet paper भी नहीं है. घास भी उससे साफ कर रहे हैं. Sorry. हाँ.
No, it's very like those guys get like a shock that what? But it's fun and. Even now, so there's a difference I've also seen in the society. Like earlier when I started off, everyone was like very shocked that what is this, what is this. Now I know like everyone has a lot of knowledge about it. And they know that, you know, poker is actually, they have separated poker from gambling, I feel. It's actually, it is a mind sport. If you put your mind to it, if you, like the kind of study I have to do, like if somebody calls it gambling, my heart breaks just to hear that. Because I know I have a mental coach, a poker coach. I have to balance everything. And in poker, you have to have like a really balanced life for you to perform your best on the table.
Exactly.
And whatever you've learned over your life, like things from life, you end up using them on the poker table. And same, whatever you learn from the poker table, you end up using in your life.
Yeah.
So it's in general, your decision-making power and your strategic acumen all really improve. And
You know who I blame for the misconception though? The Hollywood movies. Like in the Hollywood movies, what happens is the hero is down on his luck, like he's like at the edge of his sanity, and the only way he can become rich to, you know, have something in his life is by going into an underground tournament that's happening like somewhere shady.
Lock, stock and smoking barrels.
Usme bhi hua hai, but this new show also that's on HBO right now, This Is Us. Like that is an entire subplot where the guy goes like in a shady Italian guy's hold, and then, you know, he has to like challenge him and he wins a hand, then they beat him up and all of that like shady stuff happens. Rounders, the movie Rounders, even that, like, you know, he's playing with the mafia and all of that stuff is happening. So the misconception comes from the fact that it's a last resort thing. It's like when you want to break big, you know, all of a sudden in some plot.
As if you can never have played poker and go and play with people who play every week and win money.
For sure, for sure. No, it's not. It's actually like, so when you do stock market, you need to like know a lot. Like you have studied about every stock, you know, have information. It's not, you're not gambling, right? Because you know, when you're hedging and you're doing all these things, you know what's happening and you're doing those calculations. Poker is exactly like that. If you think that you're not a good poker player, don't play high binds and lose your money. You play smaller stuff till you are able to beat the bad players. If you call yourself a good poker player, you should be able to beat the bad players, which are the smaller stakes. So you have to first beat the small stakes, and then if you give yourself the naturally the time to grow, you will grow. But if you think that I'm going to go hit and run, take some money, go play a big tournament in Goa or Macau or Vegas or something, you're doing a wrong thing. It's like having no knowledge and you're just like, that's gambling. Then you're really gambling. But if you are studying, like I study more than I play. I sit down with my coaches. I review my hand histories. And
so what's a day like as training as a poker player?
So basically, if you, I mean, I'll tell you a day in Vegas, okay? First, tell me, what do you expect Vegas to be?
Drugs.
No, being a comic, I expect to wake up at 1. And then go and stare at people for like a few hours and eat and then come back to the hotel room and do a show. That's what I see it as.
A lot of my friends see it like partying. They think that we're going there, having fun, going to different restaurants, shopping, like enjoying, doing activities. Right. But the only time I really do an activity is just after like playing 20 days straight poker or something like that. I wake up like at 8 a.m. there, get up, go for a swim, work out. You know, then we have to eat on time so that, you know, your brain's working. It's a mind sport. Your brain has to be fully relaxed. You need at least good sleep. And then it has to be like completely working. So if you are, so say, I say like 2-3 hours after you've had your breakfast, you're fully like functional to take decisions. So if I have to report to a tournament at 11 a.m., I start my day way early and then I'm there playing the whole day. And these tournaments are 3-3 day tournaments. Right. So you make day two, you make day three, you make like that, and then you play for 12 hours every day.
Right.
You need sleep. And then once you're free, you have to take care of your body, you have to work out. It's so important to like, and then whenever the 1 or 2 days that you think that, okay, now I'm going to have fun, that is the time when you sit down and catch up with your friends and talk about strategies and talk about what went wrong.
Yeah.
And even if like there's some small tournament happening, you feel like, oh my God, there's so much return on investment if I go play that. Because in India, there are no tournaments, right?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
There you feel like, okay, let me play. Even if there's $100 buy-in tournament, I want to go play it. Because
yeah.
Like there'll be at least 10,000 for the first place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you feel like taking those chances and giving yourself more and more chances. Like, and in poker, if you do, if you're not doing well, you can always just take a step down.
Yeah.
You know?
I fold.
No, take a step down and go down your stakes.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then again, level up and work your way up.
I give up very easily. I either get too cocky or I'm just like, you know what, I'm not even participating. I'm like, I'm all in, go.
I'm the guy who will win 5 rupees and then just give the finger to everyone for 6 minutes. Ki like, dekh, main jeet gaya.
Yeah.
I'm that guy. For me, it's all cartoonish time pass fun.
Yeah.
I love watching it when people know what they're doing though. Does it ever happen to you that you hang out with your poker friends and non-poker friends and all you talk about is poker with your poker friends?
Yeah, so basically I have been, like a lot of my friends, they tell me that I'm obsessed with poker. I only, like they just say that, you know, there's more to life. Like, yeah. Can you like look at other things? Mm. And I have done that, okay? So, yes, I know, and it's a very like addictive game. You get really, really into it, and that's exactly what happened to me when I joined. I was totally into it. I, you know, from having no desires in life, I suddenly became like someone who wants to win this, wants to win that,
yeah.
And I'm getting angry with myself that why am I not able to do this?
Yeah.
Like I did everything right, still I got unlucky. Oh my God! Like getting really like you know how what they say, like just like my. The spiritual self was getting like mixed with all these materialistic stuff, and I was getting lost in that. So I really took a step down. I met up with my mental coach, who's like the world's best mind coach, Elliot Rowe. He works with MMA artists, he works with he works with Wall Street professionals and poker players. So he had like, he sat down, he opened up my not just personal life but professional, and he asked me, what are the steps am I doing to become a better poker player? And then I realized that, you know, I'm not really like, you know, behavior, like basically your daily pattern,
right.
Your discipline,
right.
What time you wake up, how much time you're giving to your body, your mind. Like when you're playing poker, there are so many parts of your brain that your brain is using, your body is using to make decisions. You got to really know what you're doing and have that, even if it's a 5% advantage. You need to have that edge on other players of eating right, sleeping well, and knowing everything. So my mind coach told me that relax, look at it as a bigger picture. Look at it that you just want to be the best of yourself, and you're going to take your time. And some people, they win in like the beginning. Some people win in the middle. Some people win in the end of their career or whatever this is.
It's like life.
It's like life. You just have to keep going. It's like a journey. You have to enjoy, play every hand to its best, and every chip will belong to you.
Awesome.
So that is something like, don't think about the outcome, the results. Don't think about it, because, you know, when, for example, a cricketer, like a lot of us relate to cricket.
Each innings is a fresh innings.
Yeah. So, and when a batsman is batting, if he starts thinking about everything or what the crowd is saying to him or what, like how he did not well, the last over went and stuff like that, he will not be able to perform.
Yeah.
So you got to just stay in the zone. Keep pulling out your own game. Like even if you're playing amongst your friends, later talk about it, that what you could have done better or differently to make more money if you had a bad session. And if you had a good session, then also review it so that you know that these are the things that help you.
I think the more we talk to people from different disciplines in life, the more we see the same kind of commonality. Like the same things, you know, we just discussed with Prashmay sir also, ki just living in the moment, taking it as it's coming, not thinking of what just happened.
Actors, comedians,
everybody, I think brokers. The recipe is very
boiled down to the power of mind, to be honest. And it's it's something that I can vouch for, that I have gone through so many things. I'm also like, you know, one school growing up, watching Bollywood movies, right. Hindi movies, like having that, just a normal idea of life, like yeah. that, you know, this is how it's going to be. I was angry with that, in fact.
Were you like, planning to get married and all?
No, so I was very frustrated about all that, that this is going to happen to me, you know, that like one day my parents are going to marry right. me off and this, that. I used to have lots of fights in the house. I'm a middle child. I used to anyway feel neglected all the time. And I used to always tell them that, you know, like, I used to always be jealous of my younger brother, that, you know, like, you're giving him more this, that, like, you know. And then I became very independent sort of thing, that, you know, forget this boy girl thing. I just want to, like, I want to be myself. I'm going to make my dreams come true. And to be honest, like, for the longest time, nothing really was happening. And this happens to all of us. We get into this sort of a depression sort of a thing that, you know, nothing is, we expect things to happen for us. And when you put your mind to it that, you know, what am I, if you want something different in life, you got to do something different. So there are like so many things we do wrong. Like I still have to improve my eating habits. Like I'm a big foodie. I love.
Tell us about it.
Tell us about it.
So we have to, like, you know, as a person, you have to work on yourself each day, and then you just become the best of who you are and what you want to be. And it actually has come down to the power of mind.
Awesome.
Be honest.
Awesome.
Cool. Well, let's take a small break at this point. We'll be back. More conversation, more stories with Muskan. And it's getting very interesting. So we'll take a small break.
And just be back.
News.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please make sure that you are. We are IVM Podcast on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I have a little bit of news for people. We are releasing a new version of our app, and as part of that, we're running a beta program. We have about 40 slots left for different users to participate in the beta program, and if you'd be interested in doing that, please go to our website, ivmpodcast.com/appbeta. That's ivmpodcast.com/appbeta. Over there, you'll be find a form which will let you submit your email address to us, and we'll invite you into the beta. Again, it's a limited availability, so we're only going to be able to invite so many people, but if you're interested, please do subscribe. And this week on Cyrus Says, Cyrus talks to stand-up comedian Saurabh Mehta about moving from HR to comedy and positioning himself as the first giant stand-up comic. On Simplified this week, the guys talk to Atul Churamani of Magna Sound about the golden age of indie pop in the 90s. On the season finale of the Kinetic Living podcast, Coach Urmi spoke to fellow NTC trainer Kunal Rajput, and they talk about kettlebell sports, powerlifting, and how his dad, a Mumbai-based bodybuilder, inspired him to pursue his fitness career. And starting November 19th, we have a very exciting project. We're starting our first history project with Muskan Sethi. It's called Echoes of India. Please do catch it on the IVM Podcast app, website, or wherever you get your podcast from. And with that, let's continue on with your show.
Welcome back to Varta Lab. We are here in conversation with Muskan Sethi.
Hi.
Pro poker player, national award winner.
National award winner. What is this national award that you have won? And who is this president that you have met?
Okay, so basically, when I was playing a tournament in Vegas, and I got an email from the government. They said they're looking for me, this, that. And they contacted. I got really scared.
Like, okay, we're coming back to India.
I got a daily, like, you know, what's happening, what's happening. And then I found out that basically they have selected me for this national award. So when I came back from that show in Barcelona, I came back to India, and then suddenly earlier I thought I'm the only poker player in India. Okay. And then when I came back, I see like so many more people, other women also. I met so many, like, all age groups, all shapes, sizes, everything, right. Like people who are into poker, right? So I was very, very interested to, like, you know more and get into the game in India. And just like that, I got the opportunity to be a part of this poker journalist in India. There was a woman poker journalist in India, and her name was Rupal Bansal, and she, like, you know, introduced me to this website, poker website, and I endorsed them for 1 year. So that was the first time there was a professional poker team formed in India. And I was a part of that. I was one girl, and there were three more players. And there was Amit Jain, Kunal Patni, and Aditya Sushant. Aditya Sushant won a bracelet as well in the tag team event. So it was just, so we guys were the first ones. I did it for a year. I was like, okay, I'm going to see how it works out. I did it, but I was not able to find time for, you know, family and other stuff. So that's when I got too obsessive about poker. And I took like a break sort of thing. And then I independently started doing it. And now I'm with PokerStars India. And I play online every weekend. You'll find me playing online there and everything. So I didn't know that I'm India's first professional poker player on record. And like, so basically, I was doing a lot of charity, which got noticed probably because, like, I'm sure the government must have been like that. You know, what is this girl doing that she's
what we are
like,
not doing
that
doing.
She's yeah. donating like so much or something like that. I think that's when I was even contacted by some other official also about my donations and stuff. So like, they really got into everything, and they selected 100 women who are first to be in a male dominated field. They picked up they were like, even like fighter those frontline fighter girls, like you know, and then the pilots, and there was like paratroopers and like different like, there was the first woman who made like a online payment, MobiKwik. There was like first woman to go to Mount Everest. Like, there were, you see those list of 100 women, I was like in tears that I am like counted so in badass. That like it was just so amazing. Like the first woman in Indian cinema, the first woman here or there, like, so sitting amongst them for something that I didn't listen to society, like, you know, I followed my dreams and I'm there, and like that was the time when I felt it was like justice. I brought my parents like that, you know, respect that I didn't play with their name and reputation and anything like that, and I followed my dream. And to be honest, like, all those women were interested in poker because we all searched about each other.
Right.
So we were like, they were, when I got there, everyone was like, you're the poker player. And they just like, you know, like pounced
sure
on me.
Tattoo.
They were like, I want to know everything. My tattoo is really meaningful, by the way.
It is. It really is.
So it's basically two swans because my mom used to call me her white swan. My parents, my pride. I actually wanted to do my mother, my pride, but I thought that my dad would get it. Yeah, so it was a good decision, like a poker player. And going to Rashtrapati Bhavan, it was just like, each room they took us to, like, so respectfully, and they showed us that this room, the history went down, this is where Gandhiji, this is where Nehruji signed this, this is where this happened, that happened. It was like, and even in general, how the Rashtrapati Bhavan, like, the room works, like, the lighting system, the code language, and like everything.
Is
like,
there a bunker underneath?
Office? No, so if you're like, there's a lot of like, the architecture is beautiful, like, you know, it's mind-blowing. It's like, you need to go and sometime take a tour or something there. It's just like,
hopefully one day
we'll also win something.
You've done something meaningful.
Yeah,
yeah. So that was very interesting. I was with even like really like sports, with like a lot of sports women also. So they were also interested in poker, and they were like, this is a mind sport.
Nice.
For sure. And I know our country's chess grandmaster, Tanya Sachdev, and I know our the memory champ, Vaishnavi, Shri Vaishnavi. So
that's so amazing, and there's so many notes you all can share with each other.
Yeah,
also,
so you know, these girls also, we talk about poker so much. We also went for this like a thing together where, you know, we like hanging out and talking about like poker, chess, mind sports, like memory competitions, everything, and it's so similar. Someone can actually juggle between these, and the students who are into numbers should really get into this, because there are a lot of free rolls that are happening on PokerStars India all the time. You can go play without a single rupee and really make money out of your skill, and in general be able to do better in life than later, because you are able to, you know, do these things and calculations.
That's great.
Awesome. So like, would you say like your family comes up a lot in your conversation, as we already know? Do you think they are like a very strong role model for you, including your siblings and your mom and dad?
I lost my mom in 2014, and it was like a very sudden thing, but so for me, that was, that's the year I came on that TV show as well. So I actually started playing poker to hide myself, like, you know, that I'm playing online. I stopped going for any birthday parties, nothing, not like no social interactions with the world, and I because, you know, when you see others moving on, you feel you can't relate to them anymore, and then you need time to just recover, and like, a mother is just everything to us, right? So for me, it was a big shock, and then I got out of it through poker. Because, and I just feel like my mom is always like kind of supporting me, like wherever she is from heaven, like, you know, sending me those vibes. That's why things work out and I'm still able to follow my dreams and I am where I am. And my elder sister, she's 13 years older to me.
She's a homemaker.
Yeah. And she's a homemaker. She has two beautiful sons and she spends her most of the time in just like, you know, their education, their this thing. So even to see that, it's, I have so much respect for that.
Yeah.
Cause like, that is something that I want to be like, like such a good mother or such a good sibling, like how she is to me. She's like, you know, she calls me and I'm like her little doll, you know, like if I, you know, when I do if I'm not running too good in poker or something and I call her, actually like in 1 minute she'll brainwash me and she'll be like, you know, relax, like, you know, there's more to life and you're gonna do well, like and she's very interested in tarot cards, so she'll quickly take out my tarot and she'll be like, you're about to win a tournament. And then I just become like, okay, okay. Okay. And my younger brother is, he's into
the
marketing,
of like picking a card to determine a game of cards.
Yeah, that's, yeah, I told her that, you know, both the women are into cards. And my younger brother also, my younger brother hates poker, okay, like he, I tried to teach him so many times, I've tried to give him like money that here, this is your buy-in, you know, like you, whatever you win you can keep, and you know, he's like, can I keep the whole buy-in instead, like,
so I don't wanna. I relate to your brother. I am so much like your brother.
Yeah, he's like, I'm not interested, can I please not do this, like he's just like, he just, and I feel so heartbroken. I'm like, okay, fine, like I'm gonna, like, you know, then I look at my nephews and I'm like, I'm gonna teach you, and they're like, Masi, we're not interested right now. And like, it's cute, but they play bluff with me, they play all those games and it's so much fun, like
cards are always in general just a great way to spend time.
My grandmom used to play cards, like I've never, I was born very late, so I never got to meet her, but I've heard that they used to call her Gigi. So Gigi for great gambler.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, nice.
Like all the kids,
I thought it was J-I-J-I.
Like, yeah, like even I thought, like, you know how you respect like Gigi, you say, in like a lot of Indian families.
Yeah.
But it was like for great gambler. Apparently, she used to be very good in like bridge and other games and stuff, and
so
rummy.
Genetics is also at play here.
Yeah, little bit. And
still the sequel to the Govinda movie.
Yeah.
Gambler.
Thanks.
Gambler.
Yeah, so when I tell my Masis and all, like when they say stuff like that, you know, why are you into poker and all, so they, I say that, you know, even like my Dani used to play and all, and they're like, no, you're too much. You don't compare yourself to your nani and, you know, get away with it.
GGG.
Yeah. Exactly. They're like, she was just GG, you're something else only. I'm like, okay. So basically, she used to also win a lot of money from all the kids in the family. And then all those kids used to steal it back from her,
because
that
time
was their like pocket money. So, and I wish I got to meet her. I'm sure, like I even now I'm trying to teach my father how to play poker, because he's retired and he's at home most of the time. So I tell him that please play online and, you know, do something, because he also used to do a lot of you know, stock market and stuff in the middle. So I'm sure he has that natural knack of it, and I can really get him into this. So that's one of my challenges. If I'm able to get my father into poker, it'll be like a dream come true.
And if we can get our dads into stand up, that'll be
And
but
in
surprisingly
general,
enough, like I released a video, just like a small segue. The sketch that I released for my tour, I don't know when we'll release this, but it'll be like very long after that. And like, I am an open homosexual, and you know, it's like very difficult for my mom to grasp that sometimes, because I talk about it in my stand up and everything. So I made a sketch which we shot in our house when my mom and dad were not there, and I got two actors to play them. And you know, I was like, when they see the video, they'll be very scandalized that I shot this in our house, and the whole thing revolves around parents reacting to a child coming out in a positive manner. So, and the end scene of the sketch is the actors opening the cupboard and taking out like a Kandani dildo. That's the whole, payoff of the sketch. And I went home yesterday and my mom had seen the sketch, my sister shared it. I was trying to not show it to her, but when she did, my fear was like, now she's going to be like, how dare you do this, you're maligning our image or whatever, because that's the kind of conversation we've been having for the past 2-3 years since I've come out. But yesterday, weirdly enough, you know what she said, like, how dare you open the cupboard in front of strangers. That's what the whole thing came down to. I'm like, okay, she's not saying it, but she's saying it, you know? Yeah. So it feels good, like, when you have your moms or your family on your side for something like you're doing.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, you know, it's for a cause, it's for a reason.
I promise you, I'm not, like, going in any basements and undergrounds and doing all that. Like,
you're not taking money from the Italian mom.
No,
or anything.
I'm not.
Yeah. I can't make the promises. I'm going to a lot of
business. A lot of people used to ask my mother also that time that, you know, where does she get the money to play all this? Dude, in poker, you can actually make money from the scratch.
Yeah.
And it's not something that you have to, like, put down to get that much back. It's actually something you just need your skill. Mm-hmm. And also, I wanted to tell you something very interesting. I'm leading the Delhi Diehards team for GPL, which is the Global Poker League.
Which is not Gokuldam Premier League, as shown on Tarak Mehta.
No, please, guys. GPL is basically an international poker league. Mm-hmm. And now they're coming to India.
Yeah.
And this is such an amazing opportunity. So hear this. Mm. There are 6 teams. And their qualifiers happen already, the online qualifiers for each city. So there's a Mumbai team also. It's called Mumbai Jet Setters.
Okay. Nice.
And Kavin Shah is your manager.
Okay.
I am heading Delhi Diehards. And my other team, PokerStars Pro, Aditya Agarwal, he's heading Kolkata Creators. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be, and there are other pros as well. Vikram Kumar from, Chennai Sharks. Mm-hmm. And then there's Vidwat Shetty and Abhishek Rathore. Mm. So now basically what happens is we all will have like 5 players each in every team, including myself, and whichever team wins a package worth $30,000 each to Bahamas in 2019 January.
Yeah.
And there's a tournament that you're now going to play if you win the package, which is the buy-in is for $25,000. So it's, and there's close to 10 million price pool, like, it is just going to be huge. Mm-hmm. It's going to be like the biggest tournament that ever anybody has seen, and 5 people from India are for sure going
to Bahamas.
Yes, and it's going to be one of these teams. And so if you've missed your chance to participate this time, there's going to be season 2, there's going to be season 3, that's just going to happen all the time on PokerStars India. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's so important to, like, try your luck. Like, I am actually looking for people who not necessarily need to have the skill, but just the passion.
Yeah.
And I will, you know, coach them and I'll get them to where they want to be.
To all prospective poker players and passionate people, Muskan is looking for you.
Yes, I am.
And
please.
When will this happen in India, though? The dates?
So it's happening now. Like, so the online qualifiers are just about to finish.
Okay.
So on PokerStars India, you'll see there's a separate slab that's for Global Poker League. Right. So you can see the schedules there. Mm. And then we have the boot camp on 8th September. That's when the whole show is starting. And basically, you'll be able to see a lot of it, like, on streaming. Look out for Global Poker League. Follow the social media channels, and you're gonna be updated.
This is exciting.
I'm gonna try and stream it.
In India, legality around poker is still a little murky. Can you?
No, it's not. No? To be honest, has been. To be honest, online poker is obviously really fine. But my only issue right now is that we are not very transparent or very clear about the poker rooms and other stuff. Mm. So there will be a time when I feel the government should really step up and do something about this as a responsible gaming ambassador for AIGF. Like, I have been trying to make some sort of efforts in really getting this problem solved. So, like, how in the UK, everything is legalized, and that's how the government is making so much money.
Yeah,
like, they have the UK lottery also, and the government is doing so much charity with the money that when nobody wins, like, they put it in charity and stuff like that. Mm. If they say that poker is gambling, fine, make it gambling, but regularize it so that we are in safe hands instead of being in black market, or people who are in the gray area. And it's going to be safer for us and more women to come out and play, and not just this, but other sports also. And our country should really, like, you know, highlight sports people if they really want sports persons, because it's so difficult for a child, for you to convince a child that listen, when you grow up, be a tennis player and make or bring or get Olympic gold in Olympics versus a .com millionaire. You know, you're not able to convince because the situation is so different, right? And nobody gets any rewards of being a sports person. So the government should really look into these things and realize that it's a lot of stuff is already happening in the country. Yeah. If they take it in their hands, we'll be in safe hands.
Yeah, absolutely.
Also, the guy who goes around spray painting poker around Bombay.
Oh, you know, I
have respect for you.
Yeah, I have found out about that. What is that?
It's just some guy going and playing poker on random. Yeah, my favorite one is in Warsaw though, where it's like one slab of the wall is poker, second wall is Jesus loves you.
So I asked somebody in Bombay. I told them that, you know, that I have been reading these things a lot, and they told me there's a gang in Bombay called Poker. Okay. So they keep riding poker everywhere.
And one more is like, our dost kele mendi coat. That's also one of those common ones.
Next to my office, we have a Bindas Bhabi. So I don't know what to make of all these.
Alright, thank you so much, Muskan, for joining us.
Thank you so
much.
You're
such an inspiration to so many people out there who want to play poker and understand the game. Mm-hmm. The GPL is happening. If you want to sign up or if you want to learn for the next season, do it now. Go to pokerstars.com and
pokerstars.in.
Pokerstars.in.
Yes.
.in.
Because you have your own special India site now, and awesome. You can play everything legit.
Done.
Sounds great. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you so much, and keep doing the amazing work that you guys do. I'm going to be watching you guys regularly.
Please click subscribe.
Subscribe. And you know, notify first. When you upload anything, I'll get a notification.
For sure. Awesome. How can we find you on the internet, Muskan?
So I'm on all the social media platforms like Twitter, Instagram,
Facebook.
Instagram
you know about.
Yeah. So it's actually just Muskan Sethi. Mm-hmm. Muskan Sethi 5 on Insta, Muskan Sethi on Twitter. Yeah. And on Facebook. And you can always I'm going to be making a lot of videos for PokerStars India School now.
Alright.
Mm-hmm. So you're going to see a lot of me there.
Alright. Awesome. That sounds great.
And like your pretty face deserves to be out there.
Thank you.
Awesome. So that's it from us. I'm Naveen Narona. You can find me on House of Narona.
And I'm Akash Mehta. You can find me as Kuch Bhi Mehta.
We'll see you next week with a whole new episode and all new stories on Varta Lab.
Bye.
Look, up in the internet. It's a meme. No, it's a cat video. No, it's the Geek Fruit Podcast.
That's right. We interrupt this riveting broadcast to tell you about our show, the Geek Fruit Podcast, where Tejas, Dinkar and I, Jishnu, talk about everything in pop culture, including DC, Marvel, Star Wars, Netflix and everything in between.
You know how your friends hate it when you ramble about some nerdy crap and you just want somebody to listen to you? Well, sorry, there's nothing we can do about that, but come listen to us ramble and it'll almost be like the real thing. Kind of.
Listen to new episodes of the Geek Fruit Podcast every Monday and the Geek Fruit Bulletin every Thursday on iTunes, Google Podcasts, the IVM app, or wherever you listen to podcasts. Happy listening, you nerds.
How aware do you think you are of your laws and rights? Do you look up to laws when you are caught up in situations? Do you know what your rights are when you're stuck somewhere bad? Well, here's a show that can help you move an inch closer to being aware of what your rights are. Tune in to Know Your Kanoon with me, Amar Rana. This is a podcast meant to answer all your law-related queries. Catch Know Your Kanoon every week on the IVM website or the app or anywhere you get your podcast from.